What's up, guys? It's Trav, and I've had a long week. I'm just gonna be totally honest. The snow hit, been trapped, and then, like, I've been going to work with the slushy stuff on the roads and stuff, so it's been a thing. But, you know, I'm just gonna film in, like, a really casual form, just freehand, because it's a simple video. It's not, like, a legit review. So I hit up Dayton about the review crew collab for February, and that I wanted to take up the mantle. Like, I wanted to be the one to, like, because like, we've had volunteers. I remember curbside, they volunteered. So February's review crew collab is by yours truly, and I wanted to the crew. I just felt like if I didn't take the idea, then somebody else would, because this is pretty obvious. I wanted the crew to give some love to the snacks. That means you're in between meals, the meals you're supposed to not have, the ones like later on after a meal and you feel a little hungry again. You have this, the snacks, the chips, the little dessert, the snack, the dessert, what are they called? The little cakes, the Hostess, the everything. Brought it down to my top five, but /6, because I count these two things that are in there as like the same thing because they're very equal. But keep in mind, this is stuff that I could get during the winter storm. Walmart got hit so hard with just like there was nothing. But I managed to get my favorite snacks. It's just one of them is kind of like a representation of what I like. So are you ready to see my favorite snacks? Drum roll, please. Booyah. Like what my wife said, a whole lot of orange is in this. And it's okay because it's all my favorites. I have said many times in my reviews that I really like cheese snacks a lot. It's just what I kind of gravitate towards, and a lot of new cheese products or new Cheez-Its or stuff like that have gotten pretty high scores in the past because, you know, you can't really help what you like. So, a little close-up of each thing, you know. Obviously, you know, I don't know why I'm starting with the dessert, but Reese's Big Cup is just, you can't go wrong. You just can't really go wrong with that. Ever since the Big Cup released, I can't go back to regular Reese's, and neither can Ashley, so, I mean, it's not just me. Reese's Sticks is just something that, like, I ate as a kid, and, like, I just kind of found out, you know, in the past few years, like, I still like them as an adult, and every now and then, I get the extreme craving for Reese's Sticks. Chips Ahoy, this is the one that kind of represents another one. This was all I could get at Walmart at the time. I actually prefer this exact thing, the chocolate chip cookies, because I'm just a crunchy chocolate chip person. Unless they're baked, then obviously the gooiness is perfect then. But like chewy chocolate chip cookies sold in a store, I'm just not really about. But I really, really like the Great Value version of Chips Ahoy. Like, well, I mean, it's basically what it is. But Walmart brand cookies, for some reason, I think actually are kind of better, call me crazy, than regular Chips Ahoy, but this was the only one that represented that. Even though I love Chips Ahoy, and I love Chips Ahoy original, but the one with Hershey's was the closest it got to just like regular chocolate chip cookies in a package sold in a store. Cheez-Its, another example of Walmart had nothing. I had to get the family size because it was like a couple boxes left of this. So, you know, you can't really go wrong with Cheez-Its. The original may not be like my favorite flavor. I actually really, when I reviewed that with Buffalo Wing Cheez-Its, those were out of this world, and I think they probably are my favorite. But I had to get the original just to represent Cheez-Its in general. This doesn't necessarily mean I only get these. It just kind of is like original Cheez-Its, you can't really go wrong. Goldfish. I grew up on Goldfish, and I kind of recently got back into them. Never mind the opening of these. I've already got into this. See them fish? Salty and cheesy and just really crispy. I really like them. And here's the proof of, like, when Ian did the review of these on a live stream, he gave me a little shout out because I said in the chat, because he's like, I'm going to try the Applewood smoked, the smoked cheddar Pringles. And I said, my favorite Pringles, because they really are. Ever since I had these, I just, there's no other flavor that beats it for me. Absolutely. They're just so good. So shout out to Ian for trying them and dedicating it to me. That was really cool. I just love them. They're just very, he said pungent, and that's really the word for it. I wouldn't have been able to, like, come up with that word, but he did, because he's, you know, he's Ian. Like, where do I even start? Let's just show off some goldfish, I guess. This is going to be a little unveiling of everything, I guess. They're so, when I look them on camera, I get this perspective, like, they're just so covered in, like, saltiness. It's crazy. Here's what the Applewood smoked cheddar Pringles look like. They're very, very, I mean, again, cheese related. But these just have this just really bold flavor to them that is just so overwhelming, but in a good way. Like, I could just eat on these like all day and be totally fine. Perfect movie snack, show snack, whatever, gaming snack. I love them. Another salty and just cheesy snack. And I don't know, like I said, the original may not be like the best, but can't really go wrong with them. And so it's like, if you can't choose what Cheez-Its you want to buy when you're shopping for them, I guess just get original if you really are having that hard of a time. But don't walk out with none. You'll regret it. Chips Ahoy, very classic. As you can see, most of them already been eaten. Hey, I don't have to actually open all these for the first time in this video. No rules. It's my collab. Very chocolatey. Just craziness. Like, I don't know, guys. Like, all this might be boring to you. Like, this is all boring snacks. Like, I'm excited to see what the crew snack on, because it's, like, it's gotta be more interesting than this. And yes, I would pick, I'm a chocolate chip cookie person over Oreos any day. I love me some Oreos, but if I had to choose between, like, regular Oreo and, like, regular chocolate chip cookies, it's gonna be chocolate chip cookies. I just grew up on them, and it just, they've always stuck with me. Since I'm pre-handing it, I had to actually be able to open these. But, man, since the big cup has came out, it's just, it's no competition. I can't go back. And, like, a lot of you like the pretzels inside them. It's like, I just want all that peanut butter. Look at that. You can't really go wrong. All that peanut butter. So much, like, these are my regular Reese's now. And I know some of you, probably in the crew, I won't name names, but I guarantee some of y'all will have Reese's up in there. And, you know, whatever version you have, no judgments. But I hope somebody throws Big Cup in there, because they are on another level. Little size comparison there for the Reese's Sticks package. This is the king size with four sticks. And, you know, decent size, but you get four, and I'm pretty satisfied every time I eat them. And there may be, you might not be as full once you eat these as, like, you know, you might not be as satisfied as, like, the big cup. But, you know, I think the thing about Reese's Sticks is I feel like I can take longer to eat it. So that's why it's satisfying, if that makes sense. There you go. It finally focused. You got those layers. That's what I was hoping for. The chocolate on the outside. The wafer and the peanut butter layers, that's just really something special. It just adds a little bit. You know, I wouldn't say, like, I would choose these over a big cup Reese's, but these are still, like, I just get a craving for these every now and then. And, I mean, it's just, there's just something about them. It's so satisfying. So that's pretty much it for me, guys. Let me know in the comments your, like, top 5, top 10, whatever you want to name. I don't even know how many the crew are doing, like, I basically just gave them, hey, do your favorite snacks. And I just kind of limited mine to, like, top 5/6. And then, you know, just roughly in that area. And it was really hard. There was a lot of other contenders, like Mike and Ike's and stuff like that, that I kind of forgot to include. But, you know, there's a lot of snacks that I just, not always in my arsenal. Like, it's not, but it's just, like, these are the things. These are the first things that are on my mind if, like, I go to the gas station and get a snack or whatever. But obviously, all the links to the entire review crew will be in the description. And go check out every word, dropping all of our videos all today on the 21st. You guys have a good one. Like, share, subscribe, and all that beautiful stuff, guys. And you beautiful people, see me in the next one. Drive out.